two grafts with one small scion. 1. Avoiding waste. Most grafting techniques require the loss of the lower part of the scion. Whether you use the whip and tongue, the cleft graft, or the modified cleft graft, making a bevel cut will waste at least one of the last buds of the scion. When you receive a small scion of a rare and expensive variety, wasting that last bud can be avoided, and you can use it to make an additional graft, doubling the chances of preserving that variety. Start by planning the location of the bevel cut, making a cheap bud graft. Locate the last bud and gently remove it with a narrow strip of wood. Start by doing a 45 degree small cut below the bud. Take extra care when cutting through the bud. Using a rocking motion is the best option. Make an identical cut on a suitable rootstock. Place the chip in the slot, adjusting firmly at the bottom. Adjust the length of the cut to provide a better fit for the chip if needed. If the chip is too narrow for the slot, place it to one side, so the cambium layers cross at some point. Using a plastic strip or parafilm, tie the chip, starting at the top, so it doesn't move. If you use plastic, don't cover the bud. If you do, you will have to cut it after 2 or 3 weeks. If you use parafilm, the bud will be able to break it easily when it starts to grow. Doing the main grafting technique. Now, refine the bevel cut according to the technique you will be using. In this example, I am doing a whip and tongue graft. The bevel cut is done in the same area where the chip was removed, and no additional part of the scion is used for the graft. An identical bevel cut is done in the rootstock. Here, I am making a tongue in both cuts. Adjust the cuts so they match without overlapping. Tie the graft with plastic or rubber tape. Here I'm preserving a scion bud, so I avoid covering it with a rubber tape. I finished the graft covering the scion with parafilm to preserve moisture. Protecting the grafts from the sun with aluminium foil will avoid dehydration and sunburn. Results. After 1 month, the whip and tongue graft is growing nicely. The cheap bud graft has healed but is dormant. That happens in some cases. When grafting earlier in the season, most cheap bud grafts start to grow in the same season. Remember to remove all rootstock growth below the grafts. More information. Check the technique specific videos in the channel to find out detailed information on the grafting techniques used in this video. The video 4 best techniques using dormant scions explains in detail the main grafting techniques. You can also check this detailed video on sheep budding. Links for these videos are provided in the video description. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to the channel to avoid missing any of my upcoming videos. If you enjoy my work, don't forget to click the like button. Leave a comment and share the video to show your appreciation. Be sure to turn on all notifications on your device so you know when one of my videos is published. Next week, Z-grafting, when your scions have a larger diameter than the rootstock. In July, grafting citrus trees, changing varieties. Thanks for watching.